crew standing by to break it all down for you. WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf is live outside the Dome. She'll tell us about the special place where many Crimson Tide fans spent their day getting pumped.
But we begin with WDSU reporter Simley Chewin live in the French Quarter, where you could hear the chants of football fans and the humming of cash registers all day. Simley?
Absolutely right, Norman and Scott. But unfortunately, this night is not going exactly the way LSU Tiger fans had hoped. And I'm not sure if that's being reflected here in the crowds on Bourbon Street right now or not. I was expecting the street to be completely cleared while the game was going on. But because LSU isn't having that powerful showing many fans had hoped, it appears many of them have spilled out onto the street, maybe to try to forget that the game is going on outside and to just continue with the revelry. But when we were on the ground earlier today, we ran across numerous crazy fans, both LSU Tiger fans as well as Alabama Crimson Tide fans. Basically, wherever you go, everybody jumping in front of the camera, trying to tell us why they thought their team was number one. We caught up with some of them and hear what some of the crazy things they had to say.
Tonight's game is going to be about power and execution, and that's what we're going to display tonight, power and execution. Roll Tide, Alabama, number one, the real number one. Roll Tide, Roll Tide, Roll Tide,
Roll Tide. Roll Tide. Roll Tide. LSU, baby! Yeah.
So they were certainly having fun before the game. Now the mood is a little bit different, some dejection, but clearly the winner of all of these, the businesses here in New Orleans and the French Quarter. In fact, because 250,000 visitors were expected to visit the city this weekend with the economic impact of $500 million, businesses are saying this is like an early Mardi Gras for them. All the hotels in the city are sold out, all 38,000. And in fact, the business here on Bourbon Street that we're at actually told us that they're doing tenfold better than they would on a normal January day. So clearly, they're the winners in all of this. But right now, we're going to turn it over to Rachel Wolf live outside the Dome to tell us how things are looking over there.